Good morning. The entrance hymn is number 309, Gather Your People.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Thank you. of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world,
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may merit what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, you shall not molest or oppress an alien, for you were once aliens yourselves in the land of Egypt. You shall not wrong any widow or orphan. If you ever wrong them and they cry out to me, I will surely hear their cry. My wrath will flare up and I will kill you with the sword. Then your own wives will be widows and your children orphans. If you lend money to one of your poor neighbors among my people, you shall not act like an extortioner toward him by demanding interest from him. If you take your neighbor's cloak as a pledge, you shall not return it to him before sunset. You shall return it to him before sunset, for this cloak of his is the only covering he has for his body. What else has he to sleep in? If he cries out to me, I will hear him, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed be my rock, extolled be God my Savior, you who gave great victories to your King and showed kindness to your anointed. I love you, Lord, my Savior.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know what sort of people we were among you for your sake, and you became imitators of us and of the Lord, receiving the word in great affliction with joy from the Holy Spirit, so that you became a model for all the believers in Macedonia and in Achaia. For from you the word of the Lord has sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and in Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we have no need to say anything. For they themselves openly declare about us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve the living and the true God, and to await his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, says the Lord, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory.
When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to them, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning, everyone. How are you? Good? Just in case that you didn't know, on October 1st this year, less than a month ago, me and 58 more people went from New York to Israel, to the Holy Land, for a pilgrimage. That was November 3rd. November 4th, November 5th, November 6th, November the 7th, boom, the fight, the war began between Gaza and Israel. We were in Bethlehem that morning, and even though we didn't know that what was happening outside, you could hear the sound of the rockets in the air, shh, boom, shh, boom. After the tour guide set me aside, said, "Father, we are at war right now." I said, "No, you're kidding." "No, Father, we're at war, seriously. Something happened in the border, and you better be aware of that." I left the group, they were having the mass. I went to the stairs, which leads us to the cave in which we believe our Lord was born, and I began to cry. All of a sudden, I felt that somebody sat next to me. He gave me a hug, and he only said, "You're a Christian, right?" And I said, "Yes." "You're a priest, right?" And I said, "Yes." "Father," he said, all will be well. Just have faith. I turned, I saw the guy, and he was, first and most, he was not Christian. He was not from Israel. He was a Muslim man from Syria, and then he said, Father, all will be well. To just have faith. You never know who comes into your life at the right moment, at the right time. And sometimes those people who comes to you are not even known to you. You expect the most unthinkable things from the stranger, from the needy. There is always something that that person can teach you, can give you. There is always some room to learn a lesson in your life. And those biggest lessons in life comes to us through humble people to unknown people. My second adventure happened 3 months before I became a deacon, 11 years ago. I went to Africa for three months. I was sent to a small village in the north part of Burkina Faso, which is 99% Muslim. We went to a village, we went to a school in which in the classrooms there were more than 50 students, half of them boys, half of them girls. Beautiful children, very smart. I asked them how they were doing. They said, oh, we are good, Father, thank you. And in my mind, I said, how can you be good living in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of the desert, no water, no electricity, no nothing basic. If they want to get water, they have to walk for 2 hours back and forth every day just to get something to drink, something to use in their homes. And I ask them, how can you say you are good when you have such limitations in your life? And one of those girls raised her hand and said, you know what? Perhaps we are suffering right now, but we hope that tomorrow things get better. And I said to myself, boom, there you go. And my third story to you, you will know myself now much better. When I go to confession every 2 weeks, I go to the same priest, and I always begin my confession in the same way. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. Father, I confess that I have not been a faithful priest because I have not loved my God with all my heart, with all my soul, and with all my mind. And that made me feel upset. Because when I see that my God died on the cross for me, when I see that I have received so many blessings in my life for which I am not grateful for, when I see other people having less things than I do, and they're happier than me, I understand that I should love the Lord with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind. When I complain that I don't have peace in my life, I remember those people in Israel right now. They're suffering, but I'm suffering according to my knowledge. When I see others walking for 2 hours just to have a glass of water, and then I complain that my water is a little bit dirty, I should love the Lord with all my heart, with all my love, with all my heart, with all my soul. In other words, my brothers and sisters, life is a gift. Life is beautiful. Life is gorgeous. Life is precious. This is our lives. And we must live it as it is, a gift from heaven. In the gospel, the Lord says, which one is the greatest of the old commandments? You shall love. But love, which is not a feeling, love, which is a commitment, love, which is a promise, love, which is a self-giving thing. The Lord loves us so much that he gives us blessings 24/7. Let us just open our eyes, open our souls, open our hearts to realize how blessed we are, how many beautiful things we have received. And all of them has to lead us to love God with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our mind. When we love the Lord, you have to love your neighbor. You have to love your husband, your wife, your children, even those who betrayed you, even those who denied his or her friendship, even those who sold you out. You have to love the whole world, because in each person you find God's presence. That's why in the first reading the Lord says, you shall not oppress an alien, for you were once aliens yourself in the land of Egypt. I had that experience just 3 weeks ago. I received that consolation from a person who was not from my own race, who didn't speak my mother language as well, he didn't even share my own faith. But he was there for me when I needed someone. I'm sure that at one point in this life, you should also experience something like what I experienced, because the Lord comes to us in so many beautiful ways in those moments. And you, when you need the most. My brothers and sisters, as the responsorial psalm says today, I love you, Lord, my strength. When you feel that you are falling apart, when you are feeling that you are falling down, remember, the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our hope. The Lord is our certainty in life. Whatever you have in your heart, whatever you have in your mind, whatever is happening in your soul, just remember, the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our all in all. Love your God and love your neighbor as you love yourself. Our world needs at this moment so much peace, so much reconciliation, so much forgiveness, that we should begin to do that with ourselves and with the people next to us. When we come to church, we always say at the beginning, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. It is because I repent and I want to change my life, that you, my Lord, becomes my life, my strength, my fortitude, my life. When we come to church, we empty ourselves and say, Lord, fill me with your graces, fill me with your blessings, and all things will be well. Now, when we go back to our houses, when we go back to our places of work, when we go back to the real life, perhaps we can be a blessing in somebody else's life. You never know how just a simple good morning, how are you, God bless you, I love you, I miss you. You cannot imagine how much that can mean to somebody else. Just be good, do good, and all things will be well. And finally, as the Lord also says in the gospel, just remember that the whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments: love your God and love your neighbor. Let us become messengers of divine love. Let us become the recipients of God's holy graces, and also an instrument of that mercy of God. May Our Lady, our beautiful mother, our beautiful queen, must show us the way to always love our Lord with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our minds. Amen. After I left Bethlehem, I received a text message from this man, the one who gave me the hug. He said, Father, I know that you also believe in God. He said, pray for me, because I'm still praying for you. And that's a gift. You never know how God comes to you in the most unthinkable and unknown ways. May the name of God be always praised and worshiped. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. In your books, please go to page number 9, and all together let us profess our faith. Page number 9. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, as Jesus taught us, we come to God with confidence, bringing our concerns for the church and for the whole world.
For pastoral leaders and preachers, for dedicated liturgists and educators, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For patient peacemakers and negotiators, for compassionate leaders and honest lawmakers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace in the many countries throughout the world marked by war and conflict, especially in Israel and Palestine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who carry new life and those searching for a reason to enjoy it, that they may be comforted in the hope and joys life brings, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this assembly, for all their loved who have died, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sick, the Brombeck family, Marlene Constanza, Robert Fortier, Maria Gallagher, and those listed in the bulletin, that the Lord will restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those that have died in the peace of Christ, Mary Louise Calabrese, Terry Bosom, Elizabeth A. Hayes, Loretta J. Pelaya, George Oppitz, Carol Yensko, Gladys D. Vargas, Myla Umali Ortega, Robert F. Wilner, Kathleen M. Wilner, and especially for Myla Umali Ortega and Graham Keaton. Let them be welcomed into the company of the state and the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. In a few seconds of silence, let us present to God our own prayers and needs. Most merciful Father, you are our strength and our refuge. Hear the prayers of your people, which we make this day through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
The second collection today is for the support of World Mission Sunday.
The offertory hymn is number 404, This Alone.
One thing I have.
every day alone. Oh Lord, bring me to your dwelling. Hear, oh Lord, the sound of my calling. Hear, oh Lord, and show me your way. One thing I ask, this alone I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all my days. For one day within your temple heals every day alone. Oh Lord, bring me to your dwelling.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice might be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, as whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess
your resurrection
until you come. Amen.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we prayed upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you, everyone. Peace be with you.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We will ring out our joy at your saving help and exult in the name of our God. The communion hymn is number 486. Christians, let us love one another. Christians, let us love as we share the true living bread. Jesus is our God and our brother. With his flesh and blood we are fed. Everyone who loves is both
Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. Amen. I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you.
A couple of announcements for this week. Remember that this Wednesday is the Solemnity of All Saints. Therefore, this is a holy day of obligation, which also has a Vigil Mass. The Vigil Mass is on Tuesday at 5 p.m. here in the church. And on Wednesday, we have Masses 7 a.m. and 9 a.m. Also, Thursday, November 2nd, is All Souls Day. We have also Masses 7 and 9 here in the church and 3 o'clock in our cemetery as we pray for all our deceased ones. At the cemetery, the schedule is 3 o'clock in English, 4:30 in Spanish. And finally, our sisters, the Columbiates, are running a fundraising for all the work they do here in other parishes as well. This event is called A Night at the Races. So it's going to happen on Friday, November 10th at 7 p.m. in one of our hallways, on one of our halls downstairs. So flyers are available in the back of the church. What can I tell you at the end? Love your God and love your neighbor as you love yourself. Remember, St. John of the Cross says that when we go to heaven to see Jesus, our Lord is going to ask us just one question. how much did you love? And he said that at that moment, we're opening our chest, showed our Lord our heart. And it depends how many names you have in your heart, you will receive your payment. Let us fill our hearts with so many names that we can love our God with all our heart, all our mind, all our soul. Amen. Please stand. Let us pray. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we now celebrate in signs, we may one day possess in truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and the snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by all the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world,
seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen. Let us say a special prayer to Our Lady for peace in the whole world. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O most holy Mother of God, that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ. Amen. Our Lady, Queen of Peace.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Have a blessed Sunday, everyone. God bless you.
You too, Father. The recessional hymn is number 487, Love Has Come.
With one voice,